Today is January 11th, 2023. This is my 192nd episode for C++17 2023 CUDA SQL OpenCL OpenCL TBB Vulkan. This is my 22nd episode for vector calculus. This is fifth episode for line integrals. In this episode, I will discuss natural parameterization. In some text, it is written like this: natural parameterization. If natural parameterization this term is unfamiliar with you, from Thomas's Calculus 13th edition, chapter 11.1, parameterization of plane curves, you have to read this chapter very carefully, especially for natural parameterization. Also, in Calculus 9th edition by James Stewart, chapter 10, parametric equations and polar coordinates. Chapter 16.2, line integrals, page 1135. Example 4. Problem B is a typical example for natural parameterization. From Thomas's Calculus, scroll down, chapter 11, parametric equations and polar coordinates. This chapter is simple and easy, but parametric equations are very important. In this chapter, if you scroll down, you can find in page 655 the graph of any function y equals f of x can always be given a natural parameterization x equals t, y equals f of t. Please solve a few problems about natural parameterization. Also, in the calculus by James Stewart, if you scroll down, chapter 10, parametric equations and polar coordinates. This chapter, as I said previously, is very simple but is very important. I haven't covered about these things, but eventually you need to be familiar and proficient with the parametric equations. In this episode, we will solve chapter 16.2, line integrals. If you scroll down, you can find example 4. We will solve curve C2. This is curve C2. We will do line integral along this curve C2. In this case, this curve has parametric equations. In this case, we are using so-called natural parameterization. Once again, this parameterization method is called natural parameterization. I assume you have watched my previous videos listed here from episode 191, Vector Calculus 21. Double-click this link. If you haven't watched my previous video, episode 191, Vector Calculus 21, you probably may not understand what I am doing. Show in folder, unzip, rename 192, copy, paste it in your working directory. Open up Visual Studio Code from CPP17-2023 Parallel folder 192. Double click this file. Ctrl B. In our previous episode, we learned example 4, part A. In this video, if you haven't watched this video, you may not understand my current session. Now, Ctrl Home. I will overwrite this part. You need updated C++ library extension. Before filming video, you can Ctrl click. After filming video, you can Ctrl click this link to download updated C++ library extension. I will pull it up. Control N. In our previous episode, we implemented this function. In this function, we create tuple for fxyz. In this example, this integrand is represented as a function xyz. In this case, in this integrand, we don't have z, okay? We don't have z component. So this is redundant. Fz is redundant. I will handle this part. Now open up your command prompt. Dir cd 192 line integrals clang plus plus sdd c plus plus 20 line integral dot cpp ltbb 12 oc.exe hit enter clsc. It works as in our previous episode. Now I will remove comma and this part we removed from this equation, redundant fz. If I restore it, this fz is redundant, so I remove. Right click, go to definition, just open it. If you scroll down, this one, this is the function. Now copy up to this point, copy, paste. We are overloading. Scroll up. This is generalized case, general case. Now scroll down. This is for xy plane. We don't need fz type. I removed, so we don't have fz type. I will rename fxy, so it should be fixed. It should be fixed. We now do not have this term. I will simply remove, then copy, paste it here. Type, this is type, we don't use t. I removed. We can do this, we can do type t, but we don't use t. Return type is type. With this we can delete. Instead we are returning, we are returning 0.0f or 0.0 depending on the return type. We fixed like this. Now the remainder is the same. In this case we haven't specified fz type. This is for xy plane only. For generic case we can use this function. Now it should work. In this case we do not have fz. With this we build again. CLSC, it works perfectly. Now copy this, paste it here. Now we are solving example 4 part B, a typical example for natural parametrization. In some literature this E is removed. Now in this example our curve C2 is defined like this, so we have to define this curve here. This is our curve C2. X equals 4 minus, let's see, 4 minus y square. minus y square. Our range is from negative 5, negative 3, from negative 5, negative 3, to 0, 2, 0, 2. We will let x is a function of y. In this case, y changes from negative 3 to positive 2. Now here, we can't use this one. Instead, CNA, BC, TR, 3D, R, this position vector R, R over T should represent this curve, okay? This curve. Now, here, in this case, x is function of y, f is function of y. Y runs from negative 3 to 2. So, SED floating point over t, this is for x equals f y. We let y equals t. Well, we can just let y here. Okay, we can just let y here. Then return this equation like this. 4 minus y times y. We can just do this. Comma. Now, SED floating point over. It's now confusing. What should I do? X? Or what? It's begin to confuse. Instead of doing this, let T. Y is T. So it should be T, T. Also, let T. Then return, we are defining Y equal T. So this is T. We need one more element. This is vector. So we set 0.0. This is for Z, 0.0. So we defined R. Now the remainder is the same. Here Y or T runs from minus 3 to 2. Here, we have to pass the value of T, negative 3.0, positive 2.0. This is correct. This is wrong answer from our previous episode. In this book, if you scroll down, you can find this answer. Y runs from negative 3 to positive 2. This is the answer. Copy, paste it here. So it is 40 plus. This is plus. Okay, 40 plus 5.0 over 6.0. This is our answer. Please be careful about this part. 40 plus is missing. Plus is omitted. 40 plus 5.0 over 6.0. So this is the answer. You have to be careful. Now we perfectly solved. This is natural parametrization. Okay, in some text, E is missing. Copy, control and paste it here. Disable it. With this, we build again. CLS C. see. Wow. Our numerical result matches algebraic solution as in this book. Now, this part is very annoying. Okay, this part is very annoying. If we delete, it does not work. Let's try. No, it does not work. So, to address such problem, what do you think I will do? Of course, go to definition. CPG calculus, CPG vector, press F12. Now, we are in cpgvector.hpp. In this file, from here, copy, paste. We don't need this, but we have to provide float or double. We don't have png. Instead, we place float. So, this is another class template argument deduction guide. Okay, another class template argument deduction guide. We need to create corresponding constructor. We have to create corresponding constructor. Control End. If you scroll up, you can find class BCTR, function X, function Y, function Z, this class. We have to create another constructor of this form. So, I copy, paste. This represent constructor. We don't have FZ here. This is constructor. Instead, for FZ, we initialize 0.0f. It doesn't matter. As long as we pass one float, it should work. So, we introduced new constructor, then new class template argument deduction guide. This form must match with the constructor. Also, must satisfy the concept. With this, now control end. In this case, we removed, for example, we removed chat. We can remove. It should work. CLS, we build again. CLSC, it works perfectly. In case of XY plane, we now don't need to specify element for Z. In case of XY plane, we don't need to specify Z element. It's much cleaner. Don't forget, we have to pass the range for Y in this case. In this case, we have to pass the range for Y. If you solve a few problems in this book, you can completely understand. You can completely understand such problem too. Try to solve it yourself.